Hi there, welcome back. Well, this guy's back out on the bench, and the reason is very simple. I decided to put to the test one of the suggestions or one of the ideas that came up in the last video that I did on connecting the Bluetooth to this Grundig 3160. Now, at the time, in the video that I'll link above, I mentioned two possibilities. In fact, there was a circuit that relies on the fact that the magic eye goes off when you select the pickup input, which is where your Bluetooth's coming in. But then I jokingly said that perhaps a microswitch would work better and simpler. And I decided to look at this a little bit further. And there's an expression in Portuguese that says, mais sorte que juízo. And it literally means more luck than brains. And I think I had a case of this here. I've got very, very lucky. Let me show you what I'm talking about. If we look at the switching that happens at the back of the switch assembly, you'll notice something interesting. I've got the pickup selected, and I deselect, select, deselect. Now, if you look carefully, you see that guy over there? Well, that guy goes in and out quite a bit. You see that? It goes in and out about 1 centimeter when you select it. They all do, but I'm interested in this one. Now, what I've noticed is that when I select pickup, that thing goes back 1 centimeter. When I deselect it, it comes out. So I figured, well, what about putting a little microswitch in here? And just by chance, there's actually two holes in the chassis. Right, one of them is right behind there. I think you can see that hole there. And I went ahead and bought some microswitches. And I found that I can actually fit one of these things in there without much of a problem. Let me show you. I bought two types. This is just something they had available in the one shop that I have in Madeira that sells electronics. I didn't want to wait too long. But this is a little microswitch with a lever. You can sort of hear it. This one is a little bit bigger, but the idea is the same. When the lever is depressed, the switch is made. When I say made, it can actually be opened because this thing's got a common and it's got one contact. There's three of them, as you can see. One contact's normally closed, one contact's normally open. So if you look at the switching that I've just shown you, when the pickup input is not selected, that lever is at the back. So that would be sort of pushing down there. When you activate it, it would be opening it. In other words, this is the normal situation. This is the activated situation. So what I'm looking for is the contact that will make when I release it. And that's pretty easy. I'll show you. I've got the multimeter on continuity beep function, and I've connected to those two. Now, those two are obviously open. When I click it, it makes the contact. Okay, now what I'm going to have is I'm going to use the other one, which is the one that'll be normally closed, so that when this thing is in the radio and that is depressed, that switch is off. As soon as I activate pickup and that lever moves forward, it'll open it and make the contact. Now, what I want to do there is actually just use it as a switch to switch the ground of the supply rail that goes to that board, switch it on and off. Now, as you probably know, that board has got the 6.3 volts AC going to it. Either one of those can be switched. So if I put the 6.3 volts direct and I connect the 6.3 volt ground, the ground connection to one of these points, then I can actually just connect the other one anywhere to the chassis, which is ground. And this thing will work as a switch for the power supply. So let me see how that gets done. Now, I figured I could fit this in like that. And that would be the lever over there. And putting this bolt through here And I've actually put three nuts on here, and the three nuts give me the height that I need off the chassis to put that lever at the right position where that wafer will come back and activate the plunger over there. Then on the other side of the chassis, in other words, on the top side of the chassis, this thing goes through that hole, and I can then put another nut and a washer, probably a lock washer, and see if this works. Let's try it. Now I've fixed that in place. It's actually pretty rigid. At the moment, it's not depressed. Pickup is not depressed, so here goes. See that? I selected something else. When I select pickup, the contact is made between those two points on the switch. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to connect this ground point, which is just over here, and I've actually already soldered a bit of wire to it. Connect that to that point over there on the switch, and from the negative of the socket that I'm using to supply the Bluetooth module, I'm going to bring a small wire down here and connect it to that end of the switch. And then we'll test it, see if it works. Now that one end is soldered to the chassis, the other one is soldered to a little black wire, which comes out, runs across there, up there, that black one, and it goes through that hole to the socket on the power supply socket, that power supply socket that I've got on the top there. Now that's being soldered in. And now we just need to put this back in the chassis and test it. Okay, we've got everything back in. Now let me test it. I'm going to switch on, just put it on long wave for now. And now I'm going to hit pickup. Boom, there's the Bluetooth. Right, I can close this up, turn it around, and we'll do a final test. Okay, so here's the test. We've got FM. If I push TA, which is the pickup, you hear that? Let's try again. Listen to the tone of the Bluetooth coming through. There we go. Bluetooth's active. So now we have Bluetooth working perfectly only when we pick up, when we connect the pickup input, which is exactly what we wanted. It wasn't necessary to put in all that detection circuit. I had a relay, I had a transistor. That circuit works, but in this case, and as I said, probably more luck than brains, this thing actually had a very accessible contact point where I can use the sliding of the pickup to actually activate that microswitch. And I'm sure that this is not going to happen to many sets. This one just happened to be convenient. But when it is convenient, this is certainly the simplest option. That switch costs about €1. And it's just a simple switch to ground. You can switch it to the local ground because that's all you're doing. You're supplying the ground to the 6.3 volt AC supply to the board. Well, I hope that's been informative, and thanks for watching. If you've liked this, click like, share, subscribe, and all that jazz, and I'll see you back soon. Stay safe.